Oh friends, this is Hope Channel and you're watching Praise Forever. It's an educative and yet entertaining program. So it's edutainment program and my name is Cheikh Omangombe. Today, without any guest singer, but educating you about music genres from a biblical and yet from a musical point of view. And this will be referring more from the SDA music philosophy. Somebody doesn't know if we have our philosophy of music. Let me just tell you that we have our philosophy of music. And maybe you don't know where you will find it. Into your Google page, just type SDA music philosophy. It'll be there. PDF format, you will download, you will keep it for yourself, you will read and reread and understand with the help of the Holy Spirit. Now I know we have heard or read that we are shunned from using musical genres or related hybrids like jazz and rock music in our services, in our homes too, but maybe you don't know what is jazz music, what is rock music, or what is reggae music, or what is blues music. Today, I just want to get a little deeper about these genres. I just want to post a disclaimer and note that every example of music taste you will hear in today's program, every genre will just be for education purposes and not for any judgment purposes. So please, just have an ear ready to listen and a mind which is ready to discern this stuff. We have to know what a genre is by meaning. A genre is a conventional category that groups together some pieces of music that share a set of conventions or traditions. And today, most of my publications will come from the SDA music philosophy. We are reading from the SDA music philosophy as a result of the official action of the Autumn Council of the General Conference Committee of October 14th to 19th, 1972 in Mexico City, Mexico. Care should be exercised when using a secular tone wedded to sacred lyrics so that the profane connotation of the music will not outweigh the message of the text. Moreover, the discerning Christian, when selecting any secular music for listening or performing which is not included in the categories of jazz, blues, rock, etc., will subject such music to the test of the principles given in the general principle outlined in this philosophy of music. Now, please tell me if you can just differentiate these music genres just from listening. Though I know there is a name for each genre from the video clip coming next.
Arsenal or infantry, I'm built for this mentally. That's why I'm the general, I do what they pretend to do. Front on me now, nigga, I'll be the end of you.
Try to do the land. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he was a buffalo. and he had it going. He'd let me drive her, we'd haul off a load down a dirt.
These musical genres actually bear children. This is to say they have hybrids. Most of today's music is a hybrid music. It's not so easy to find a music that is just very specifically relating to a genre, or a music that is just very purely played from a genre like jazz or rock or reggae. But here it is, classical. Opera.
La donna è mobile, qual piuma al vento muta.
Ragtime. Polka. Jazz. Folk.
The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. Yeah.
Country.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, down, down.
Soul.
It's been a long time coming.
Blues.
I see trees of green, red roses.
Doo-wop.
Still, Jove, Jove, of the night. Jove.
Gospel.
Instead of me, he took
rhythm and blues. Metal. Funk.
13-month-old baby. From the looking.
Disco.
Brother, you're a brother away. You're a mother. You're staying alive. Staying alive. We're the city breaking the name.
House.
I made no promises. I can't do golden rings. But I'll give you everything.
Pop.
Tell me why.
R&B.
No one, no one, no one.
Hip hop.
Cause when I was low, you was there for me. You never left me alone because you cared for me. And I could see.
Reggae.
I wanna love you and treat you right.
Dance hall.
Sim Sima. Who got the keys to my bima? Who am I? The girls, them sugar.
There's just a lot. I just mentioned a few of genres and sub-genres. Oh, most of this music is just very senseless. I even wonder how we dare use them in our choirs. In fact, the STA music philosophy tells us that music such as blues, jazz, the rock idiom, and similar forms are inimical to the development of Christian character because it opens the mind to impure thoughts and leads to unholy behavior. Such music has a distinct relationship to the permissiveness of contemporary society. The distortion of rhythm, melody, and harmony as employed by these styles and their excessive amplification dulls the sensibilities and eventually destroys the appreciation for that which is good and holy. Who wants to distract holiness in God's worship service? Oh, God help us.
Music is the language of the soul. For thousands of years, humans have been creating songs and symphonies which enthrall, inspire, and hypnotize. Our history and our culture is closely entwined with musical notes. It should come as no surprise that music has a profound effect on the human mind. We've all felt it before. Music helps us relax. It gives us goosebumps, and it encourages us to push ourselves to the limit. But what's the science behind all of this? Here are seven psychological facts about music. The Mozart Effect. The Mozart Effect is one of the most popular scientific concepts surrounding music. It was developed by Dr. Gordon Shaw a few decades ago, and the premise is simple. Classical music makes you smarter. In his research, he claimed that listening to classical music can raise your IQ by up to 9 points. The main basis for this line of thought has to do with spatial reasoning. This type of brain activity is used in math, chess, engineering, and science. According to the Mozart Effect, classical music boosts spatial reasoning considerably. Maybe it's time to start playing some Mozart while we study. Music therapy helps repair brain damage. Brain damage is one of the most discussed topics in the world of psychology. Some people suffering from brain damage go through tremendous pain and discomfort, and their life is seriously impacted. But what if music could help? New research shows that music can actually repair brain damage, and it's been hypothesized that music therapy could be responsible for neurogenesis, which is the birth of new brain cells. Hearing music in your dreams is incredibly rare. Think about every dream you've ever had. Can you remember hearing music in a single dream? If you're like the vast majority of the population, you've probably never heard so much as a jingle in your dreams. According to a 2018 study, only 6% of all remembered dreams include music. Unsurprisingly, you're much more likely to hear music in your dreams if you're a musician or someone who listens to a lot of music. But even then, the number is still very low. Your entire brain is activated when you listen to music. There aren't many activities that make your whole brain light up, but listening to music is definitely one of them. When you listen to music, there's not a single part of your brain that isn't activated. Parts of the brain that are responsible for emotions, creativity, and even motor functions are working while listening to music. So if you're looking for a full brain workout, simply put on your favorite song. Music can improve language proficiency. The relationship between language and music is one of the most fascinating things in the world of psychology. To put it simply, these two things are very closely linked to one another. A 2012 study pointed out that despite what previous research suggested, music and language are not separate functions in the brain. Traditionally, speech functions were thought to exist in the left hemisphere of the brain, while music functions existed in the right hemisphere. But today, it's widely accepted that both hemispheres are responsible for music and speech. What this means is that music functions can actually improve speech functions, and vice versa. In a sense, both activities are working the same muscle. Your taste in music says a lot about your personality. Have you ever wondered why you like certain music? Have you ever wondered why your favorite songs might sound absolutely terrible to others? The answer lies in our unique personalities. Numerous studies have shown that if you like a certain musical genre, you're probably going to have certain personality traits. For example, a 2004 study found that extroverts were more likely interested in music in a general sense, but they were also more likely to enjoy pop music. That's just one example, and there's tons of research on this one topic. Think about your favorite song. What does it say about your personality? Music therapy helps children with autism. Remember what we said about music lighting up the entire brain? Well, this makes music therapy an ideal choice for children with autism. When both hemispheres are activated, children are self-aware while still forming relationships with others. Research has shown that this type of therapy is incredibly beneficial for autistic children, as it encourages them to interact with their instruments and communicate with others in a band, ultimately creating music in a collaborative effort.
Oh yes, thank you very much. We have had a documentary that is at least open up our minds to a deeper state. And now we are going to focus more on music genres with more vivid examples. I know most of people out there have thought that to have a jazz music, you should specifically have a drum. Let me tell you, it's not that true. Jazz music may be played even without drums, though yes, drums are also involved, but instead of using sticks, they normally use brushes, though it's developing to a level that they also use sticks. Now I want to give you a 1 or 2 minute introduction of how jazz is built up.
What is jazz music? Jazz music is a kind of music in which improvisation is typically an important part. In most jazz performances, players play solos which they make up on the spot, which requires considerable skill. Popular jazz instruments include the piano, the saxophone, the double bass, and the drums.
Yes, thank you. This is all about jazz. Now, we all know about reggae. We normally have a syncopated rhythm. We normally count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 in music. But in reggae, and most in jazz as well, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for reggae, you will hear da 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 da. Today, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is actually tempting us into dancing, more of dancing than just having our heart and mind and soul relaxed, waiting to hear God's word. We are normally used to hearing people sing with smooth reggae beats. It's still reggae. It's still reggae. And I will tell you some other day how blues music came into existence and how it gave birth to all these other genres. But today I want us to focus on one song. I must tell Jesus in a jazz style. I must tell Jesus in a reggae style and in a choral style as well. But let us begin with the reggae style before we get to our most loved church style, the choral style. So first, hear it in reggae.
I need you, Lord, right now. Yeah, yeah. I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear.
I hope you have not been unfaithful to your heart. I know your head was just nodding. But okay, let's come back to a jazz presentation of I Must Tell Jesus. Only the piano, but the chords are complicated, and mostly the 7th and the 9th and the 11th chords and the 13th as well, making these jazz harmonies heard even though we don't have a percussion instrument in it. Yes, thank you. Now I want to take you back to a choral style of singing, I Must Tell Jesus. It's a congregational style of singing, I Must Tell Jesus. With this, everybody in the church can sing. Everybody in the church will sing. It's not a music for the few. It's a music for all the people in the congregation.
Amen. I Must Tell Jesus is number 585. We'll sing that next. All four verses tonight. Number 585. Lift it up all together on that first verse. I Must Tell Jesus.
I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear.
This is the one we advise everybody in the church to do. All you music coordinators in the church, please make sure you have the best choice of genres to use in church or elsewhere for the glory of God. Friends, I believe you have had a good watch and actually a good session learning about musical genres and subgenres more deeply today. And I just promise you more blessings some other time, as I will have a guest singer in the studio. And I just promise you, even if you will not find a guest singer in here, it will be still an edutainment program. My name is Jacob Mangombe. I wish you a good moment, and bye-bye.